The Boundary Manager tool in AgFiniti is used to set active field boundaries to calculate available mappable acres, purchase equation-based prescriptions, and export as display setup files or shapefiles. In this tutorial, you will learn the various ways to set an active boundary, including using trace map, drawing, and import shapefile options. The Boundary Manager tool is on the Map page under Map Tools, then select Boundary Manager. First, if you have any boundary operations exported from your field display or SMS software, these boundaries will appear under the existing boundaries. If there are multiple existing boundaries, select the star next to the name of the boundary you would like to make the active boundary. If no existing boundaries are listed, you can trace the currently mapped stats displayed in the background by selecting Trace Map. Use the drop-down under Trace Map to select a simple or detailed trace. Simple will use the existing AgFiniti parameters to create the boundary. Selecting Detailed will create a finer outline of the boundary, making waterways, terraces, and other small cutouts in the field an internal boundary. Automatically create field boundaries using the desired level of detail by going to the Managing Data settings and check Create Field Boundary Automatically. This option will set the field boundary using the desired level of detail for any new data being read into the software. To apply trace boundary settings to all pre-existing fields, users can select Create Now, and all boundaries will be reprocessed and set using the selected Simple or Detailed Trace option. Any boundary can be edited by selecting the Edit icon next to the existing boundary names. In the Boundary Editor, you will find tools at the top of the mapping window. Modify Polygon will be selected by default and is used to add additional vertices to adjust the initial boundary. Add Polygon will allow you to start drawing the boundary by clicking and dragging to create a new polygon. Use Remove Polygon to delete existing polygons. Add Remove Circle is used to define center pivots in a field. If you don't have any suitable spatial data to base a boundary on, you can use satellite imagery to draw a new boundary. First, we need to find the reference image you want to use by going to Zoom Tools and search the address in the Search Address box. If this is a new field, we can create a new name to assign the boundary by going to the Field dropdown and selecting Add Field. Enter the desired name, grower, and farm name. If you want to immediately draw the boundary, check Open Boundary Editor to draw a new boundary for the field. When finished, click the check at the top to save your new field. To define a pivot in the Boundary Editor, select Add Remove Circle. Then click where the center pivot is located and drag out to create the circle. Once you have the circle placed, click again. You can also hover over the center pivot to adjust the tower location using the latitude and longitude values in the lower left corner. You can further define the tower length by entering the actual length of the tower. Once you have made all adjustments, click Add Circle. If you make a mistake, use the Undo button to go back a step at any time. Once the pivot is drawn as desired, click Save. If you would like to define dry land areas or waterways, first draw the entire perimeter of the boundary, then use Remove Polygon or Remove Circle to remove the areas not included in the boundary. Boundary shapefiles can be used by selecting Upload Shape in the Boundary Manager and selecting the zipped folder containing the shapefiles you want to use. These will then appear in the existing boundaries list for you to utilize. After you have the existing boundary data that you would like to reference created or imported, ensure that you make it an active boundary by clicking the star next to the name. Now you know the various ways to set an active boundary, including using trace map, drawing, and import shapefile options. If you'd like to see more short tutorials from AgLeader, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.